English, Grade 4, Venu's Time Machine, Block 20, Fact and Fiction by Teacher Shikha, Part 2. Student, understand that a science fiction text has fictional elements that could possibly happen in the future. Let's continue with the lesson. As we all know, up till now in the story, Venu has invented a lovely time machine. Let's continue with the story. Venu's mother was bent over a weird-looking machine when he entered her office. It looked like an armchair with several dials and wheels. "There you are. Come on in," said his mother. "Did you have your breakfast?" Venu nodded. "What are you making?" "What are you making?" he asked. "This is a time traveler," said his mother. "Don't get too excited. It doesn't work yet." "Wow," said Venu, imagining himself looking at a tiger softly padding through the jungle. "I'd love to go back in time," he said. "Back in time?" said his mother. "But why would you want to do that? We already know what happened in the past. But if you can look into the future..." Venu was about to reply when the phone rang to summon Dr. Mallika to the director's office immediately. His mother sighed and left. Alone in the office, Venu looked at the time traveler closely. He sat on the chair and began fiddling with the dial. Suddenly, the room became dark and the chair began to vibrate. Venu looked around him in surprise, wondering if he should call his mother. His eyes shut automatically. At last, the chair stopped vibrating. Venu opened his eyes. Where was he? There were trees everywhere and birds too. He had never seen so many birds before. Where did they come from? Where was he? Suddenly he heard a rustle above his head. Someone was watching him. Frightened, Venu looked up. It was a monkey climbing down the tree and staring at him. A monkey? Venu could not believe it. Was he now in the past? He looked at the time traveler and saw that the dial showing the year was turned to 1973. Venu was delighted. He searched his pockets. Where was that bag of nuts he had? He finished it out of his pocket and dropped one on the ground. The monkey darted out to grab it. Soon Venu and the monkey became friends. "I must go back," said Venu, scratching the monkey's back as it chomped on the nuts. "Do you want to come with me?" The monkey looked at him, its yellow eyes shining, wondering if he was being foolish. Venu sat on the time machine with the monkey. He pressed the button that said present, hoping it was the correct one. The monkey shrieked as the chair began to vibrate, but Venu held it close. Children, please do the reading of this lesson again and again. It is a very interesting lesson, but unless until you do your reading, you will not try to be able to understand it. We'll continue it in our next video. Have a great day ahead. Have a great day ahead, children. Read and try to understand and try to focus on the lesson. Bye-bye. Take care. Thank you.